really important to provide the right message that holds their interest and makes them want to learn more. The question is, how do you light up your business so people can find you? And one of the biggest questions I get from people all the time is, I don't know where to find my clients. I don't know where to look. Where do I go? Now I can't even go anywhere to find my clients, so what the heck do I do? Well, I'll tell you what you do. You can use Zoom on interviews and podcasts, masterminds, one-on-one interactions, just getting to know people that you never met before, and web TV. But what do I say, you might be asking, that will make people trust me and want to work with me? Well, that's a big question. If you use the words and phrases that your clients are using, or that they're waiting to hear from you, then they say, she gets me, or he gets me, he understands. In your videos, number one, do you identify your audience in that first sentence? That's really important. If you skirt around who you're actually talking to in that first sentence, you're gonna lose all the interest in your audience, because they say, well, who is she talking to? I don't know if she's talking to me. I don't know if she's talking to that guy over there. I don't know who she's talking to. How do I relate? But if you say in the first sentence exactly who you're talking to and what you're talking about, people will instantly be drawn to you if they're interested in what it is that you're doing. If they're not interested, they leave. And that's okay, because those aren't your people. You want to gain interest immediately in that first sentence by identifying who you want to work with. And then, what is their challenge? The next is your benefits. How many benefits did you describe in your video? And did you just list the benefits, or did you talk to me about the importance of the benefits and why I needed to know about them? Next, what fear or challenges were you addressing in your video? That's really important too, because if you call me in and I go, okay, and you aren't telling me what the challenge is so that I can figure out whether I want to work with you or not, then I don't know if you're the right fit for me. And the last thing, why should people work with you? What makes you important? More important than all that other noise that's out there. Why should I work with you? So now I'm going to give you a little paragraph, and I want you to listen in very carefully, because it's based on what I do with sales. And I want you to tell me if you hear everything that I just talked about. Business owners, now you know right away it's you guys, right? Because you're business owners, are frequently challenged by feeling rejected when trying to sell their products and programs. There isn't anyone that doesn't relate to that unless they're really good with sales. Agreed? So in that first sentence, I identified who it is that I wanted to talk, I'm reaching out to, and what it is they're challenged with. Now, if they aren't challenged with rejection, they're gonna leave, and those aren't my people. So what we're doing is we're honing out the people that we wanna talk to. Next sentence, what if you never had to feel that rejection again and knew how to sell without feeling pushy? Here's the rationale next. These fears make sales very difficult, because you'd probably rather be sitting on the couch binging on a Netflix series. What if you could sell without fear and rejection? Wouldn't that increase the income in your company? You knew exactly what I'm talking about. You know what benefit I offered. You know about the fears I'm addressing. You know why you should work with me, because that's what I'm going to do, is teach you how to overcome the fear of rejection of sales. I could probably say that in maybe 1 minute, but if I was going to do 2 minutes, I'd add in a couple more benefits and explain why they're important. When you do your videos, follow these questions. Who am I talking to? What benefits did I offer? What fears am I addressing? And it doesn't always have to be fears. It could be pains. It could be challenges that you're addressing and why people should work with me. If I want to make why people should work with me firmer, I'd say with a call to action in the last sentence, I've been teaching this course for 25 years. Now it's your turn to make millions of dollars just like I do.